Rose, welcome to Manchester City. We are so excited to have you here. And you're joining just a little bit after we announced your U.S. Women's National Team teammate, Sam Mewis, who had also joined the club. So this is the first time we've had two Americans on our women's side at the same time, which, again, is very exciting for followers of the Women's National Team. So what about the FAWSL is so appealing to you right now in your career?
At some point, I had always wanted to like kind of experience going overseas. I think it's a different playing style than the NWSL, and something that I think is going to challenge me and push me. There's a lot of great players in the league, and I think it's just continuing to grow year after year. So I was really excited for the opportunity and excited to play with some great players.
What are some of the biggest differences you can see between the two leagues that you're hoping will help you improve your game the most?
NWSL is obviously very physical and transitional, and you have to cover a lot of ground, and it's really hard. And I think over in England, it seems like it's very not as much transitional, more kind of tactical, technical, have to break teams down a little differently. So I think it's a side of my game I need to work on, and I'm excited to do so with the players on the team and also going up against some great players too.
How much did Sam signing at this time have any effect on your decision, and what kind of discussions did the two of you have, if any?
I was really excited that she was thinking about it too. I think I'm a homebody, so going overseas was like a little uncomfortable for me, but being able to have a familiar face and somebody that's like one of my best friends to be over there and share the experience with, I was really excited.
What is your favorite memory of playing on the national team with Sam?
I feel like the funniest thing with me and Sam and our friends on it too, we're like this like trio, but we're always like, when did we become best friends? Like, we have no clue how we even like became friends, because like me and Sam like really butt heads. Like, no one yells at me like Sam yells at me. But it's so funny, and we're always like, how are we friends? Because like we're just like so opposite of each other, but we like get along great. Sam's one of my best friends, and I like love her. I think it's been so fun to like be on the national team with her and play with her, and now I'm like, I get to be on the national team and a club team with her, so I think it's gonna be so fun. She's like one of those people that is just so funny without even trying. Like, she's one of those people that like she can do what, like, she just does, she doesn't even try to be funny, and people like laugh at her and she'll get like annoyed with it. So like the thing that I always say is, we'll be in film and a clip of her will show up, and it'll be like a really good clip of her like hustling back and like defending and slide tackling and having this like sick defensive play, and then people will start laughing, and she's always like, why is that funny? And like, I don't know why it's so funny, but like, she's just such a funny person that everything she does is funny, whether she's trying or not.
How much contact have you had maybe with some of the other North American women playing in the league who might also be familiar faces?
I mean, obviously, there's a ton of Australian players that I played against in the NWSL that have headed over. So it'll be fun to play against them again. Janine Becky, I played a little with her when with the youth teams when we were younger. So I'm excited to get back on the field with her and not play against her like I usually do when we're playing versus Canada. But yeah, I'm overall just excited. I think it's going to be an awesome experience, and I'm going to learn a lot from a lot of great players and just have a lot of fun.
Mm-hmm. What kind of conversations did you have with our manager and the club staff before you came over and when you were making your decision?
I talked to the coach, and he was just telling me about like kind of the system they play and where they see me, and it just felt like a really good fit. So that was kind of a big reason why I wanted to come over. Obviously, wanted to feel uncomfortable but comfortable at the same time on the field.
Without revealing too much sort of tactically, what discussions did you have about where you might fit in on the squad or how they see you developing to help the team?
I like to play in the middle and kind of like try to play make, so hopefully I can come in and help fill that role. And like I said before, I think there's a lot of like great players and a lot of great attacking players that hopefully I can play off and we can help each other.
You're joining the squad, obviously, as a World Cup winner. Everyone around the United States watched that amazing win last year. Now, when you played with the U.S. Women's National Team, you played against England, and now some of the stars of that squad are going to be your teammates at the club level at Man City. So what do you remember of some of those players, and who are you eager to play with?
Yeah, I mean, I think every time we play against England, it's a really tough game. I think it's kind of become a bit of a rivalry. So I'm excited to be on the other side and be playing with them now instead of against them. Obviously, Ellen White's a great goal scorer, so excited to play and hopefully link up with her. Jill Scott, Kira Walsh, excited to be able to play in the midfield with them. Steph Houghton, I mean, all of them are great players. I'm excited to be able to play with them and stand up against them like usual.
Your skills off the ball are really impressive, and your left foot is also very impressive. So tell us a little bit about that and how you bring that to your game as an individual.
I feel like everyone knows I'm very left-footed. I love my left foot. And I don't know, when I get on my left foot, I like to shoot. So I feel like I kind of, I don't know a lot of people are left-footed, so I think it's something I kind of use to my advantage.
Thinking back on your time with that World Cup squad that made so much history, you really became one of the standout stars among fans and in the press. So at the time, how much of that could you sense, and how, as a professional, do you deal with that kind of pressure during a big competition?
And to be honest, I kind of stayed off my phone as much as I could, and I think that helped. I read a lot, so I wasn't really, like, engaging in it too much. I think we also had a lot of really great leaders on the team to, like, kind of look up to, and I've been there before, so I think they were, like, a great example of kind of how to handle it and how to act, and so that really helped a lot too. And now hopefully if I go to another one, I'll have more experience and be better than I was before.
Who were some of your particular mentors on the U.S. Women's National Team squad last year?
I mean, there's a lot. I think there's so many different leaders on the team. Obviously you have Pino and Alex, JJ, Becky, Kelly. I like, the list goes on. I think there's so many people that have so many different incredible stories and experiences to learn from. It's hard to just pick one person that I've like been mentored by per se, because I feel like they've all kind of chipped in their own way. Mm-hmm.
Now, you came into the U.S. senior camp for the first time when you were still a student. So what did it feel like to get that vote of confidence from the national team manager? I mean, you watched the 2015 World Cup from home. So what was going through your mind when you got that call up?
I was nervous. I was really nervous. It was weird because it's like I've grown up watching that team and have like looked up to so many players that were on the team, and then I got into camp and I was like, oh my god, like I'm eating dinner with them. But then I got on the field and I like felt a lot better. I think each camp I like grew a little more and got a little more comfortable, but I was definitely really, really nervous at first.
How did you sort of overcome those nerves?
I think just like the more you're in that environment, the more you kind of, and like the more you're in that environment and can like succeed and do well, the more confidence you have in yourself. So it's kind of just like bit by bit, you're gaining more confidence.
And that's a really competitive squad. So at what point did you feel like you had really cemented your place in the lineup, in the roster?
Honestly, I like, it is so competitive that like, I don't think I ever let myself feel like my spot was solidified, because I think like the nature of this team is there's always like somebody kind of breathing down your neck for your spot, because it's so competitive. So I didn't ever really let myself feel too like comfortable or complacent in my role. I knew there's a lot of good people that could, and good players that like could step into it if I kind of let my guard down or wasn't playing well. So Yeah, I don't think I ever felt solidified. Or I never let myself feel solidified, I guess I should say.
Now, you scored a few really memorable goals at that World Cup. So what was the most meaningful to you and why?
One in the finals. I think we, like, the way the game was going, we were, we kind of had control of it. And I knew after, I felt like after we got the second goal, it was kind of the insurance goal. And it was like, okay, now we just kind of have to buckle down, keep playing how we're playing, and we'll have the game. So I think that one was probably the most memorable because I just felt so relieved after.
What was going through your mind when you actually won? I mean, from watching in a pizza parlor in 2015 to actually, like, lifting the trophy in 2019, what's the first thought you had?
Yeah, it was wild. I feel like when the whistle blew, it was like I could finally just, like, oh my gosh, like, we did it. I feel like anyone who's, like, been in that tournament, it's very, like, high pressure and a lot of stakes on the line. So I felt like the whole time it was, like, I was just so – like, you're just on this high. So I feel like when the whistle blew and the tournament was over and we, like, accomplished what we set out to accomplish, it was just like, oh my gosh, we did it. And then I feel like once we, like, get the medal and, like, are celebrating, then it, like, finally hits you, like, oh my gosh, we did it. Yeah, it was fun.
And when you returned to the States, and there was the ticker tape parade in Manhattan and everything that happened after that, your victory tour was, like, really famously epic. What was it like to be kind of swept up in that whole period afterwards?
Oh, it was so fun. It was so fun to be able to, like, be celebrated like that. It was awesome to see all the support that we had. Obviously, when we were in France, we had, like, a lot of people coming to those games, but then to come back to the U.S. and be able to see all the support that we had back home too was incredible. I think, like, the atmosphere that the fans created both at the games and, like, away back home was incredible. And I think that support, like, meant the world to us, and we could feel it when we were playing.
A lot of pundits have kind of tipped you and some of your peers, like Sam and a couple other players on the squad, as sort of the next generation of talent to keep the level of excellence on the U.S. Women's National Team high. Where do you see your role in sort of keeping that level up? Like, what do you do next?
Yeah, I think I'm always trying to get better, and that's, like, kind of one of the reasons I wanted to come overseas, because I thought that with how, like, well this league is doing and how many, like, great players it's attracting, and it just keeps growing every year, I thought it was, like, a great challenge for me to get better and learn in a different environment. So I think that that's, like, kind of the biggest thing, is just to keep, like, challenging yourself and putting yourself in situations that are going to make you a little bit uncomfortable, so that in the long run you become a better player because of it.
What do you know of Manchester as a city, and what are you looking forward to most about being over there and being in the environment at the CFA as well?
The club, like, it's incredible. It's one of the best in the world. And yeah, I'm excited to, like, get over there and just, like, see, like, the football culture and how everyone just kind of, like, lives and breathes it. I think it's going to be something I've never really experienced before, and I'm excited about.
Thank you so much. We're so excited to have you at Manchester City, and we can't wait to see what you bring to the squad. So good luck.
Thank you.